Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Francisca Ui, Compliance, Corporate Affairs, and Legal Directors of Bank CIMB Niaga, hereinafter referred to as the company. We have just completed annual general meeting of shareholders today, Thursday, 9th of April, 2020. Hence, we would like to share the summary of our annual GMS resolutions as follows. The first agenda, approve the annual report and ratify the consolidated financial statement of the company for the financial year ended on 31st of December 2019. The second agenda, approve the use of net profit of the company for the year ended 2019 with the following details. First, distribution of cash dividend maximum 40% of the net profit of the company, which will be distributed on the 8th of May 2020. Second, to book the remaining 2019 net profit after deducted with the dividend distribution as return earnings to finance the company's business activities. The third agenda. First, approve the appointment of Heruan Tanurireja and public accountant firm Tanurireja Wibisana Rintis and Rekan as a public accountant and public accounting firm who will perform audit to the company's financial statements for the year ended 2020. Second, approve the proposed 2020 annual audit fee of the company. The fourth agenda. First, approve the resignation of A. Glenn M. S. Yusuf from his position as the Vice President Commissioner of the company. B. Raharja Alim Hamsah from his position as the Director of the company. C. Tengku Dato Sri Savro Tengku Abdul Aziz from his position as the President Commissioner of the company. 2. Approve the reappointment of A. Jeffrey Kairupan as an independent commissioner of the company. B. Vera Handayani, Lani Darmawan, Panji P. Jaya Negara, and Francisca Ui, me myself, as the directors of the company. 3. Approve the appointment of A. Didi Syafruddin Yahya, who currently serves as a commissioner of the company, to be appointed as the president commissioner of the company. B. Glenn M. S. Yusuf as the Vice President Commissioner, independent of the company. C. Chu Mei Chuan as a Director of the company. Hence, the members of the Board of Commissioners and the Board of Directors of the company are as follows. The fifth agenda. First, approve the salary or honorarium and other allowances for the Board of Commissioners and Syariah Supervisory Board of the company of the financial year 2020. All members of the Board of Commissioners, including independent commissioners and Syariah Supervisory Board, do not receive any tantiem or bonus. Second, approve the tantiem or bonus of the Board of Directors of the company for the financial year 2019. Approve the delegation of authority to the Board of Commissioners of the company to determine the remuneration, holiday allowances, and other allowances for each member of Board of Directors of the company for the year of 2020. The sixth agenda, approve the renewal of recovery plan which has been prepared and submitted to OJK on the 29th of November 2019. The seventh agenda, approve the amendment of several paragraphs in Article 13, 14, 15, and 17 of the Article of Association of the company. The 8th agenda. First, in the meeting was reported the accountability of the use of proceeds of public offering as of 31st of December 2019, whereas the funds obtained from public offering have been used in accordance with the plan as disclosed in the respective prospectus. Second, in the meetings was reported that the 2020 Sustainable Finance Action Plan of the company has been submitted to OJK on the 27th of November 2019. Third, it was reported in the meeting the reappointment and appointment of the Audit Committee members of the company, namely A. Reappointment of Jeffrey Kairupan as the chairman concurrently as a member and B. Appointment of Endang Kusulajari as a member. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the resolution of Bank CIMB Niaga's 2020 Annual General Meeting of the Shareholder. Thank you and have a good day.